Hi, this is Stan, and it is time for me to do the radio program. But today I decided to get out of the radio studio and actually go into the Studio 77 television studio to actually do the television and the radio together. So whether you're watching this on the video or perhaps you're just listening to it on an iPod radio cast, welcome. What I'd like to do today is talk about why you, that's right, you should pick you and do something significant in this coming summer and fall, the difference in life and business. You should consider getting into the radio communication business as a part of your career and the business that you are called to do. I also decided to put on my purple tie. Now, oftentimes when I was actually in radio, I would wear a business suit because I oftentimes said, you know what, I'm in somebody's home. I'm in someone's car going with them to work, and perhaps I should just dress the way a guest would dress, taking a ride with them or in their car. So that's a little bit what I do. Even today, I always make it a part to do something like this. Now, you see, if you would ever invite me to come and speak to your group, and I'd love to do that. I've done it all over the world. This is probably how you would find me. The purple plain tie is part of my shtick. So you'll find me always with the same rather strange haircut, about the same kind of glasses, a white shirt, always a white shirt, perhaps even with cuffs, and a purple tie, because that is my appearance. That is the way I program myself to make an appearance for you. Yep, I'm kind of old guard, old school, old fashioned, but that's who I am, and I want to live fully who I am. And I like ties. I've had a number of them. And this purple kind of Trump tie, I guess, is one of my favorites. And there's actually a story of why I have a purple tie. If you'd like to hear that, well, when you invite me to speak and see my purple tie, you can ask me. Now, I'm going to talk today about picking you to be on the radio. Now, there's a wonderful story I read the other day about Madeline Engel. And she is that wonderful writer and author, supposedly children's books, but obviously for everybody. And the story was of her career and how she, for years, trying to be a writer, would write a book and submit it to a publisher. And she had, as many great writers have had, many, many rejections. You know, they just are always rejecting her. They weren't taking her work. 40, 50, 60, 100 rejections until finally one person gave her the deal. But, you know, that's the way it was. You couldn't publish a book until someone picked you to be published. And that was true for many years. But it's not true anymore. And the same thing is true for being on the radio. Somebody had to pick you. And I worked very hard at that. Oh, I worked so hard to be a radio broadcaster and then finally demonstrated what I could do. And finally, somebody said, you can be on the radio. And so I began on a program and worked my way up until I was actually broadcasting all around the world on some of the most powerful transmitters in the world. And that was wonderful. But I had to be picked because it would have cost me, if I would have had my own radio station, several hundred, perhaps not thousands, but maybe even several million dollars to have a radio station. But today, I do, and you can too, have your own television station. You can have your own radio station. And you don't have to have anyone pick you, except you can pick you to be on the radio. And here's what is happening with the revolution in audio and video, internet work, Certainly. You can do just exactly what I'm doing. No one gave me permission or picked me to be on this program. I picked myself. And no one picked me to be on the radio. I picked myself. And that's what I do. Now, some of you are saying, okay, Stan, I understand that, but why should I? I'm an insurance agent. I'm a plumber. I'm an accountant. I'm doing all kinds of things. Why should I even think about doing a podcast program? I hear you talk about it. Why should I do that? I'm going to give you some good reasons why perhaps you should do that. Now, some of you are going to say, and you're going to ask the question is, can I make any money by doing a podcast? And the answer to that question is probably not. No, probably not. Now, there are people who are making lots of money as a podcaster, as a podcast broadcaster. And you could do, because if you're really good and you choose the right niche and you've got good content and you're very creative and you will get more creative, you'll find that people will come to you and say, could we advertise on your podcast? And you could go out to some people and say, would you like to be a sponsor of my podcast? And I'll give you credit and affirmation. And there's lots of people who listen to me and see my program, hear my performance, will mention you, just as is true in every other broadcast phenomenon you see today. That does happen. And there are people who are making significant amounts of money by enjoying being video, YouTube, and audio, radio, podcasters. But you see, it's more than that. What happens no matter what is you have the opportunity to DWI. That's an opportunity to demonstrate your wisdom and insight. And part of the problem is for all of us in life and business, we could be the best offer and the best ever. And we have so much good things to give to people. But if nobody knows about us, if we're invisible, and most of us are, it won't do any good. But what can happen is as you expand your reach, I mean, I have people who watch my online programs in over 150 different countries. There's over 25,000 people who've signed up for some of my online programs. I'm very grateful for that. Now, as a result of that, I getting to be able to speak and connect, whereas a business performance coach, I, 30, 40, 50 people all around Minneapolis, St. Paul, and now it's a worldwide group of people who ask me to help them from time to time. And I am allowed to do a number of things to help them with their business. So that's what can begin to happen. So the first thing that can happen is you can begin to build a business brand. You know, you can do something that will help your business be known, be found on the search engines. You can have an internet platform presence simply because you're doing a very nice and attractive little radio program once a week, maybe three times a week, maybe even once a month, 15 or 20 minutes, maybe even less, and you are being discovered by people all over the world. Perhaps you just simply have a message or a mission you'd like to get out. This is a good way to do it. You believe in something. You're concerned about something. You've got some real convictions about something. You've got things you want to communicate to people. I have one friend who's going to start a podcast because he honestly believes that there is someone out there who needs to encourage parents who have autistic children, and he wants to start a podcast because that is a near and dear cause to him. Another person has a grandchild, cystic fibrosis, and how can she do something about helping the research and the revenue that will help to maybe eventually put an end to that childhood genetic disease? You may also find, number four, see, one, two, three, four, that there are things you would like to just teach people about. It's not a money thing. There's things about, about the Bible, about the Constitution, about how to treat one another, about how to build a business. And so you would like to be in the education and persuasion business and see if you can't actually help people do something there. Well, you can do that. Also, I have one friend. He just loves to entertain, and he's really good at it, and he knows he's not going to make a lot of money at it, and he doesn't have to worry about that, but he just loves the idea. He's learned something about, as he says, I'm a little bit cowboy, a little bit country, and a lot of gospel, and I can tell some very good stories, and I sing some pretty nice songs, and he's going to be on his own cowboy radio show. Perhaps there's something about your personal story. Everybody has a wonderful story inside of them. And your story could help teach people about something about life and business and about God. And you could promote something that you believe is worthwhile. And so storytelling is the only effective means of communication. And there will be lots of people who, if you do it well, would love to hear your story. And then find out more about you and perhaps learn from you and perhaps find a way to reach out to you. Wouldn't that be nice? So there you go. There's six good reasons to be on the radio. Now, obviously, let's go to number seven. Here we go. You will become smarter and more creative. Now, as some of you know, I've done a number of programs lately on being creative. And just recently, I kind of made some people upset because I said the world is full. And I spoke particularly of one of my dear friends who is incredibly successful. And he is highly functional. But he's missed a number of opportunities, and he could achieve much more in life if he were just practicing being a little more creative. He is really good, and he's really in the box, and he functions extremely well. Now, some of you said, well, there's all kinds of creative people who are not very functional. The dysfunctional creative is legion. That isn't even interesting anymore. There are so many of those, and you know many of them. But it is the highly functional and the highly creative person who makes the difference. Highly creative. A God-inspired maker and creator, and a God-empowered, and a God-led, highly functional following person. That's the goal. That's the goal. Jesus said, I came that you will have life. Fully alive. You're good at it. You can handle it because you're going to get dealt a whole lot of bad deals in life. And I'll be here to help you deal with the deals. That's what he's all about. And we're going to be fully alive forever. That's the deal. I'll guarantee you this. If you knew that once a week, twice a week, you actually have to come up with something to say, something creative to communicate, you will not believe how many good ideas will come to you. You will find yourself seeing things in a whole different way. Your creativity will go and grow. One of the best things I could do for my friend, but he won't do it, is just to say, you know, Jack, I'm going to put you on the radio twice a week so you come up with something worth talking about. And he's got it inside of him. He just doesn't know it. He doesn't know how to express it. And he hasn't had any practice in being creative about it. And I want him to do that. I want him to find parts of his own life, spirit, and walk with God that is new and unique and powerful. And one of the ways he can do that is to be on podcast radio. There we are. I am going to be putting together, this is actually like kind of a introduction to our whole set of courses and podcasts on how to be. We're going to help you become a world-class professional radio broadcaster in order to build your business, make your mark, and serve the world in ways that are unique and powerful and empowering to the people you help, and obviously give you great joy in the help and serving. That's one of the missions that I am beginning right now. And I just wanted this weekend to share that with you and ask you to please sponsor us, help us. We need your help. TCENglobal.org/contribute now. That would be gratefully appreciated as we make this mission take place. And contact me, radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com. We can help you make this, the rest of your year, 2019, one of the most significant years in your life, as you certainly discover it's your turn. That's right. It's your turn. Pick you. It's your turn in your town, in your community, your church, and your world. And you're on. Join me. It's fun to be on. All the best and blessings to you. I'm Stan Houston. Bye for now.